Kitchen episode. So you guys have seen in the past on the videos that I've done a Korean barbecue as well as Tilapia, and the first impromptu video I kind of did was for the cooking, or for the smoking of the ribs and the chicken. So this time I'm going to do a tilapia, but live, and kind of do it a little bit differently than last time, because last time I kind of just threw everything on, kind of flipped it, and did all that jazz. I'm also going to do some mashed potatoes, which isn't really so much cooking, and that's the easiest thing ever. Bring water to a boil, take it off, mix this in there, boom, you get mashed potatoes. So I'm just going to do a slightly different tilapia thing. I feel like I'm going to do my videos where I'm not necessarily taking certain recipes together. I'm going to be kind of changing things up, seeing how different things work, because that's the thing. You can sit there and cook the same thing the same way every time, or you can, you know, go off the grid and kind of do your own thing. So I've got two different, I kind of already prepped this one. So the thing that's going to kind of put this off the grain is I'm going to drizzle a little bit of sriracha in there. And then on top of that, I'm going to take my Lawrys seasoned salt and kind of throw that in there. Kind of mix that with it. I'm going to throw the tilapia in the little thing because there's more that we're going to do to it. We're going to, obviously we want it blackened, so we're going to put the black pepper on it. And since it was sitting on the sriracha side with the salt, kind of flip it over, let it do its thing. Over there sitting at, put the black pepper all up in it, spread it around so we get a nice little bit to it. Now the thing that's gonna separate this from the typical thing also, besides the sriracha, is soak it in a little bit of beer. Let it sit. We're kind of running around there. Get that going. So let's get this one going, a little bigger unit. Spread it around. Get that going. Flip it over. It's got the sriracha all up in it. And then same thing. Drizzle some beer all over it. Let it soak. So while we got that going, one of my burners is kind of messed up over here, so kind of gotta light it and do that. So we got that at a high. Get that one going at a high. I'm gonna take our pan. And move it back to my wheel. That's the one thing I didn't grab when prepping. And so I'm gonna use the other one. So I'm not going to use oil this time. No, we already use oil. Use this oil. I like to experiment with different things. So, but we'll do some of that. And we'll do some of the spray. Get that going. So one burner is going to be for the mashed potatoes. The other is going to be for our tilapia. So, lose my mind. Use this to flip that. So, it soak for a minute, let that heat up. No, you know what? Let's turn our vent hood on. That would be a good thing. Out of the way. Not gonna really use these anymore. They got raw juice all over it. So, you know what? Let's do this smaller one first. And that's why we have the vent hood, because the vent hood is gonna get all the steam up out of the way, making where it's gonna hot box in the house, setting off alarms and stuff. I am going to open up, not open up the window, but open up the blind. Let's get a little of that going in. So we want to get the tilapia cooked for about 2 to 3 minutes per side. So right at 354, we're going to flip it over. Get the other side going, see how the other side looks. If it needs to go back over, then obviously we'll flip it back over again.
Oh, you know what?
I fucked up. Why did that? I should have been getting the water ready to go for this. So,
it's all good. So, for mashed potatoes, just going to be 4 cups of water. And then I'm going to add a little flavor to the end of that. So, obviously, that's how we're going to wait. Got to wait another minute. See how that goes. It looks like it's getting all nice and cooked, though.
Fuck Marsha. Fuck Martha Stewart and Rachel Ray. I got this shit on lock. What is up? I am completely not realized that anybody's even watching. So, yeah. I'm just kind of bullshitting and doing this live little cooking show. I was going to do it on the YouTube channel, but YouTube literally told me that I was gonna have to wait 24 hours until I could stream, and I wanted to do it like now. So basically, streaming on Twitch, gonna drop the final video when this is done up on the YouTube, so it's almost like I did stream it on there, except I didn't.
All right, so then 2 minutes.
You want, I mean, it's blackened tilapia, so you're going to want that black and brownness to it.
Well, the black is mainly the black pepper. You want the brown on it, just
that's how it is.
So we're going to flip it back over at
356 on my time over there.
So then we're going to use this plate, not for any special reason, but just because we're going to like have this to put the tilapia on when it's done. That way, whenever we actually make the plate with the food on it, we can put one on, or we can put everything on one dealio.
I just don't feel like bringing out the big pots and pans and everything to separate everything, I guess you could say.
So, another minute and a half, 2 minutes on that side, and we should be good.
And I just realized the music's not even that loud. But also, if I'm talking way over it.
But then again, we can't have it that loud either because I don't want to get my stream shut down because of copyright issues. See, I need to get another camera that I can just put over that so you can kind of see, but then I'm also kind of worried about the steam and the smoke getting up in the way. Anyways, how's everybody doing today? So, typically on Twitch, I don't stream this. I'm only streaming this on Twitch because, like I said, YouTube basically told me 24 hours. And normally Twitch, I'll do music-related things or I will play video games. I used to have a set schedule, kind of everything got screwed up whenever my schedule got a little inconsistent with work and everything, and my personal life gone away. Basically, like 2 years ago, I was on Twitch, had a pretty decent setup on how I did everything, and a set schedule, but then like my personal life and everything kind of went a different way, same with the work, so I kind of had to deviate off of that. So, yeah, this one's actually about done. So, yeah, 6 minutes per fish is what I'm going to say. So, this one. Boom. Got that one started up. So, 4 o'clock is when that one's going to get fired up on the other side. But yeah. Like, if anybody ever wants to play games, or if you have a specific idea for a stream that you would like me to do, let me know. If you want to see more of this, we can do that. Except for I prefer to do it on the YouTube channel. And you know what? Since I have time really fast, I'm going to go and grab the new merch. Got 1 minute. Okay, just in time. So, once I flip it, I will show this and announce something else as well. Getting nice and juicy. Flopping to the other little side. This joint opened up because this is about to go also. And I'm not doing any garnish or nothing today because I actually don't have any. I thought I did, apparently the fuck not. So that's an issue. Alright. Flipping time. And then you might need a little bit more on that side. Also might need a little Alright, so this is the Deathcore Kitchen channel in a way. I mean, I am Deathcore Kitchen. It's completely my thing. There's gonna be more collaborators and stuff coming out with me. I plan on building this brand up, which is kind of the cool thing about me doing this on Twitch today rather than the YouTube channel, even though it was supposed to be on the YouTube channel. But on my personal merch store, where you can also buy my band Seeds of Discord merch and whatnot, you can go on there and buy Deathcore Kitchen t-shirts, which I might move this logo up a little bit. This is where it defaulted at. Didn't realize it was going to be so much in the middle or whatnot. But, I mean, I'm pretty stoked about it. But the thing is, since it is print on demand, I can get this shirt in any color. I can change the logo to any color you want. Let me know if you want one. And whenever you place the order, just let me know, and I can get that going to where you can have a different shirt than just what's for sale on the store. That's the cool thing about running your own merch store with that type of thing. We can get that going. Also, in the future, I will be adding up different Deathcore Kitchen related merch items, household stuff, or just different hoodies, hats, and whatever. There's also going to be another shirt that is going to be unveiled next weekend at the cook-off that we're going to, that we might put that up just as a thing. But I'm not really showcasing that one until after the cook-off. So that'll be on the following week's episode, because we're going to do a whole vlog of us at the cook-off cooking live. Well, I mean, not live, but a whole vlog thing. It's going to be pretty sick. Like, I'm expecting a minimum of 10 minutes, if not 30 minutes worth of footage out there. Get that over, see if we can get just a little bit on that side. It was fine, it just seemed not undercooked, but there's like one little spot that might have not gotten it, or maybe it's just the skin peeled off, but I'm going to let that do its thing for the next less than a minute now. I was only going to give it about a minute on that side. I don't want it burned, because obviously that's not what the fuck. Another reason I pushed this plate back when I went upstairs was because we have a dog that likes to steal shit. Food, mainly. Ooh, hell yeah. Good, and I'm not trying to toot my own horn. So while that cools down, and we get that going, take this off, go do that. Fucked up by not having this ready to go. We can go and mix all that together. Woohoo! Fucking mashed potatoes, mashing them up. And it's not just mashed potatoes, it's fucking four cheese mashed potatoes. So it's almost like I made the macaroni sauce that you would put in the fucking mac and cheese shit. Ooh. Hang on, I threw some on the floor. But actually, I guess it wasn't on the floor, it was on the counter. Boom, those are all done up. Turn that off. That's hot. Put that over there. I'm not giving this to dogs. So I don't want them shitting everywhere. So, put that. So, drink on that. Let's do some mashy potatoes over here. It's falling apart. It's all good because this can get eight anyways. So, just clean all that up afterwards. Because here's the issue: every time that you cook,
you're by yourself. It sucks because you're sitting there trying to clean. While you're basically letting your food get cold. So half the time I'm eating shit that it's good, but then it ends up being cold and I don't get to enjoy it. So this time, you know what? We're just going to make it a whole thing where I clean up after I eat. But I'm going to basically sit here and eat this live while it's still hot and fresh. So I'm actually going to eat the one that was sitting for a minute first, just because it's still hot. Honestly, I like this tilapia that I just cooked better than the one I did on the YouTube channel. One on the YouTube channel, I think I overdid it with the salt and the black pepper. And also, I think that adding the beer and the sriracha to it kind of added a whole nother thing. Which, yeah, if you hear sriracha, you're like, oh, it's probably going to be spicy. This actually isn't that spicy. Because if you think about it, it also mixed with the beer that I put in the initial tub that I was sitting in. So it kind of calmed that down a little bit. Yeah, and this shit's just falling right apart, so you know it got cooked right on point. Honestly, I probably cook this exact recipe for the rest of my life, because I personally think it's perfect. I think even my dad would probably enjoy this, and he is a picky guy. The crazy thing about me, personally, is like I like seafood, but I'm not really a big fish guy. For me, seafood, I like shrimp and lobster and things like that. I go for those types of seafood. I'm not normally like a tilapia guy. Lately, though, I've been enjoying tilapia and salmon. That might just be because they're easier to cook. And, I don't know. I mean, you're not really going to cook shrimp. Yeah, or you're not going to cook shrimp and lobster like a normal thing. You know what I mean? Yeah, so this recipe I did, definitely way better than the one I did that I actually put up on the YouTube channel. So, I don't know. Me eating this stuff live is how you know that I guess what I'm trying to say is if this sucked,
and I put it on the YouTube channel, I'll probably just go dump it out, but you're seeing me actually eat the whole thing live. So it's not like I'm just gonna go pick it up and throw it away. Like, you see that I have this full plate of food. And you saw me cook it live, so it's obvious that I didn't just go pick it up and set it for something else. Okay, this little piece I think might have got overcooked, but that was just one little side of it. The rest of it came out fine. Now I say it got overcooked because it's like kind of hard. But I don't know which, since I cooked two tilapias, I don't know which one was better, the bigger one or the smaller one. Part of me wants to say the bigger one, but that's only because the smaller one obviously sat for another 6 minutes while I cooked the bigger one. So even the bit that I said might have been a little overcooked is still fine. Like, I'm not mad about it. I don't think I've had these mashed potatoes ever, so let's see what this is about. Interesting. So the thing is, normally when I do my mashed potatoes, while I'm mixing it together, I'll sprinkle some shredded cheese in there to give it that cheesiness, but this one I didn't do it because it's supposed to already be cheesy, and it's pretty decent. I feel like it needed more water than the directions said, but whatever. So, part of me wants to just not delete the other sloppy video, but I feel like this was a better thing to do, I guess, because when I do the other videos, I'm kind of just having the camera on and letting it go, doing different things, kind of running around. I have the subtitles on. There's no audio on what I'm doing because it's just kind of like a little quick video with music playing in the background. I feel like this kind of allows me to go a little bit more in depth on what I'm doing and then having to explain it with text, you know what I mean? Yeah, I think these potatoes are a little meh. I'm not sure it tastes good, but also said I needed water. So that's that.
See, if I thought my tilapia sucked, I probably would have just did the same thing. But the tilapia was good. I felt like the potatoes, in the end, ended up just kind of being meh. It's almost like taking taking the cheese mix from the mac and cheese and just being like, yep. So,
here's the fun part. What do you have to do when you finish cleaning?
You're cooking. You gotta clean.
So, you know, let's turn our bit hood off. I hand wash all my dishes, mainly because, for one, there's one side of my sink that has a little leak, so whenever you run the dishwasher, for whatever reason, there's this little spigot piece that, just spews water out, and, it's not a good time. So I'm not trying to ruin my cabinets down there. But also, hand washing the dishes kind of makes it to where you don't have, or you have way less of buildup in the sink than you normally would. Because there's one point in time where, there was just so much shit in the sink, and the dishwasher worked. It's just nobody would, you know, do their part to help out and, you know, keep the dishes clean. So whenever the dishwasher stopped working, it was kind of the thing where it's like, okay, now everybody needs to just clean their dishes and whatnot. Now the thing is the dishwasher works, but there's this little leak, so there's still that. But I don't know. I feel personally there's times that I've ran the dishwasher and stuff still didn't get completely clean. Like, you know, it would clean it about 95% of the way and it'd still be that little bit of shit on the dish that you're just like, man, what the hell? Like, why did it do that? I feel like they shouldn't have done that. Like, what's the point of having a dishwasher type thing? So, for me, I don't mind cleaning my dishes by hand. Yeah, in the end, it kind of sucks. But for my dishes, I'll clean my dishes by hand. For everyone else, like, I prefer, obviously, not cleaning anybody else's dishes, but, I mean, sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do. So, here's the other thing. Obviously, the future Deathcore Kitchen streams are going to be on the YouTube channel, but another thing to think of is, do you want to see more of this or what? Because I can sit here and do different shit live all day. portion more exciting if I bring on guests. So if you guys want to see me bring on a guest, I will be more than happy to
bring some guests on, because I feel like if I were to just kind of sit back and kind of just sit behind the computer and run the stream rather than being the one cooking, it might make for better entertainment. Or maybe if I'm even standing next to the person that is cooking, might be even better thing, you know? So there's tons of things that we can do with the show to make it a little more fun and amusing. So the thing is, I'm doing the stream as a way for me to, well, not the stream, I'm doing the channel as a way to kind of promote new unsigned artists with my platform, showcase my love for cooking, bring on other people who love to cook, and just build a nice little community. So the only way that all this works is by you guys, the fans, telling me what you want to see. Do you want to see more of me cooking solo, live, or on the videos like I've been doing? Do you want to see me bring people in, talk about cooking and talking about music and stuff? Just let me know. And then also, like I said before, we've got shirts on our online store, which, like with every video, there's a link right there. It also has the Seeds of Discord shirts, but I've got these Deathcore Kitchen shirts for sale online. If you want this color shirt, but with the red logo, green logo, pink, orange, whatever, or if you don't even want a black shirt, you want a white shirt or green, or you know what? While we're live, I will tell you the different color options that I can get going. And the thing is, for even a little bit more money, which that'll be discussed, obviously, if you want to put in a custom order, you can get an American Apparel shirt or whatnot. And then eventually, I'm going to get hoodies and shit put up on the page, too, for this stuff. So, this website's being slow. But there's going to be a bunch of different merch. So, I can even, since we have time to sit here and talk about it, I can tell you what other merch I can get. So, if there's something specific, I can throw it up on the store. Or you can just tell me. I can just order it. I don't know why this light's being so slow today. So, actually, yeah, I can go basically any color you can imagine. Black, Oxwood black, navy, brown, red, green, blue, berry, orange, leaf. Like, there's so many different colors. So I just literally need to know what color shirt and what logo you guys would want, if you want something besides the typical stuff. I believe on the store right now, I have this one with the blue logo. I have it with a white logo on black, and I've got a white shirt with a black logo on it. But I can do hoodies, polo shirts, tank tops, crop tops, whatever. I can even get socks if you really wanted to, or phone cases, which I don't know if anybody would want that, but I can do some duffel bags or some fanny packs. What else do we have? Flip-flops. Oh, you can get towels, water bottles, coffee mugs. Maybe I can get some vinyl stickers made just and have those in stock. But maybe we can do some aprons too. Oh, they got pet products. What can we get? Maybe I can get Chappie to model one. Oh, never mind. It's just a engraved pet ID. But yeah, hats, beanie. there's a lot of stuff we can get going. So if anybody has anything specific they want for merch, just let me know. But other than that, I think that is about it for today. For an actual video, maybe the next video I do is I revisit the Korean barbecue thing because I kind of want to try something fresh with that. This tilapia, I changed the recipe up today and I enjoyed it more than the one I did on the video. Like, that's fucking crazy. So sometimes you just have to go against the grain and do things that seem like they won't work, because half the time they will. But yeah, I think for the people who actually watch this live, thanks for everyone who's going to come back and watch this later on, because I'm literally about to upload it to YouTube and it's going to sit on Twitch for a little bit. But yeah, thank you guys so much for all the support I've gotten so far, and keep supporting the channel. And let's get some new content rolling out and do some cool things.